Hi, I'm Chelsea, the Christian nutritionist. I recently heard a good comparison of there being no room at the inn for Jesus to there being no room for him in our home, in our schedule. And I was like, dang, because there are definitely days I'm like, nope, all filled up here today. Maybe there will be availability tomorrow. And you know what? My day never goes as well as when I do make the room and the space in my schedule for him. My family and I are reading one chapter of Luke each night during the month of December as we lead up to Christmas. There are 24 chapters in Luke, so it will take us right through Christmas Eve, which is perfect. But even that, which takes like no more than 10 minutes in the evenings, seems so tough to work in with all of the sports practices and homework and dinner and chores and really just pulling my people out of their respective free time zones, you know, like get off the computer or the TV or come inside. There's a lot of eye rolling and do we have to? Can we do it later? It has definitely taken some effort, but we've made room in our home and in our schedule. And it's been really rewarding. It has sparked some good questions and conversations in our family. We missed about 3 days last weekend, but we made it all up on Monday night, which was kind of an effort, but we did it and it's all been so worth it. I wish this had been part of our Christmas tradition all along, but it definitely will be from now on. So it's not too late to jump in and start in the middle of Luke if it's something that appeals to you. I really just wanted to remind you to make room. Give Jesus some space in your home and in your schedule to keep you grounded in the reason for the season. I hope you enjoyed this sermon on the couch. Have a healthy and blessed week.